Happy morning, dear students. Today's topic is coartation of aorta. This condition is comes under the obstruction to blood flow. Here, these are the conditions are asyenotic heart disease conditions. That means left to right shunt conditions. Under that, we discussed previously that is aortic stenosis, pulmonary stenosis, and now we discussed about coartation of aorta. What is coartation? Here the coartation means narrowing of the distal part of the aorta. Here, look at here this image. This is the ascending aorta. This is the descending aorta. What happened here? The distal part means descending aorta. Here the narrowing is there. So what happened? Whatever the pressure is there in the left ventricle, when the ventricle contraction, it move on to the aorta, ascending aorta. What happened here? The some narrowing is there. So because of that, unable to supply the oxygenated blood to the lower extremities. So this condition is called as coartation of aorta. All of you clear what is coartation means? Here the narrowing of a aorta. That is in which part it is there? That is distal part of the aorta. Means descending aorta is having some narrowing. Okay, that is called as coartation of aorta. All of you clear? Coming to the introduction. Coartation of aorta is a discrete narrowing or a long segment hypoplasia of the aortic arch, usually in the juxtaductal position. What is the juxtaductal position means? Look at this picture here. This is a juxtaductal position means here the aorta. This aorta is having descending aorta is supply the lower part of the body. Extremities, lower part of the body, organs, this distal part of the aorta is supplying the oxygen. Ascending aorta is supply the main organs, supply the blood supply to the main organs. Okay, look at this here. This is the normal aortic arch. Here the distal part also is normally it is there, but in the coartation of aorta, the distal part of the aorta is having juxtaductal position, means it is in compressed position. Juxtaductal means coartation. Another name is coartation, means narrowing is there in the distal part of the aorta. All of you clear? Here, the coartation of aorta is a discrete narrowing or a large segment of hypoplasia of aorta arch. Here, what is hypoplasia? Hypoplasia means increased cell production is there in the at part. Here, the increased cell production means because of some compression, here the increased cell production is there. So, it may obstruct the part, that organ part means aorta part. Okay, this is called as coartation of aorta. All of you clear? This is about the introduction. Coming to the incidence. It is accounts for 8% to 10% of congenital heart defects. If child is suffered with the any congenital heart defects, this condition, coartation of aorta, is accounts for the 8 to 10%. Okay, here the 2 times more than the common in male childs. When we comparing male and female, here the male children are more affects with this congenital heart diseases compared to the females. Okay, that is coartation of aorta. And 25% of patients with the Turner syndrome have coartation of aorta. I said in early class that is congenital heart diseases defects in that what we discussed some syndromes are associated with the congenital heart diseases. Under that the Turner syndrome also is there. If any children is suffered with the Turner syndrome, they are having this coartation of aorta. How much the percentage is means 25% of patients means our children are affected with this coartation of aorta. Okay, and next associated defects. When that baby is having this coartation of aorta, they won't have only one defect. They are associated with the another defects. For example, bicuspid aortic valve, that defix also is there, and then VSD and then ASD conditions. VSD means ventricular septal defects, and then atrial septal defects. These are the two conditions are associated defects. Mostly we will see in 50% cases. Okay, these are the associated defects of coarctation of aorta conditions. All of you clear? This is about the introduction, incidence, and then associated defects. Okay, coming to the pathophysiology and then etiology of coarctation of aorta. First, you know about what is the meaning of coarctation. Coarctation means narrowing of the lower part, means distal part of the aorta. Okay, here the just ductal part, here the coarctation is there. Okay, what happened in this pathophysiology? The discrete narrowing or hypoplastic segment of the aorta increase the workload of the left ventricle. Why this left ventricle workload is increased? Because whatever the blood is pumped is dumped in that left ventricle, automatically the ventricular contraction, the blood is move on to the aorta. That is the normal process. Whether there is no narrowing, what happen? That blood is supplies to the remaining parts of the body. Okay, that is the normal process. But what happened here, because of narrowing or hypoplastic segment of the aorta, here the increased workload of the left ventricle is there. So here the left ventricle systole pressure also is increased. In neonates with critical coarctation or coarctation, here the lower body blood flow occurs through the patent ductus. Here that is, it may result the right to left shunt. Here the right to left shunt means baby is suffered with the cyanosis. Left to right shunt, there is no cyanosis is there. Remember that. In the older children, collarates vessels grows and then bypass the coarctation to perfuse the lower body. So the main symptom in this coarctation of aorta, baby is having decreased blood circulation or decreased blood pressure in the lower extremities. Increased blood pressure in the upper extremities is there. Why this decreased and increased blood circulation is in the blood in the lower and then extremities, upper extremities, means because here the ascending aorta is having branches, three branches. What happened? These three branches supplies to the main organs. Blood circulation, oxygenated blood is supplies to the main organs, that is brain, liver, spleen, and then lungs and everywhere. But the descending aorta, here the descending aorta is supplies the blood to the remaining lower extremities. So where the coarctation is there, the narrowing is there, here the distal part of the aorta is having narrowing or hypoplastic segment is there. So because of that, the lower part of the organs was not receives the proper oxygenated blood. So it leads to the decreased blood circulation or blood pressure in the lower extremities, and increased blood pressure in the upper extremities is there. Okay, coming to the clinical manifestations, the neonate with critical coarctation, ductal dependent lesions is there. What are the ductal dependent lesions? Lesions means it is an asymptomatic until the patent ductus begins to close. Here when the patent ductus arteriosus means here the ductus is open with the pulmonary artery. Okay, the ascending aorta is having ductus in between the pulmonary artery and then aorta. Some open is there. Before that, when it is closed means within first to third week only it will be closed. Before closing of patent ductus arteriosus, child is having asymptomatic, means child is not having any symptoms of cyanosis. Child is not having any symptoms of left ventricular hypertrophy. But before that, there is no symptoms is there. After patent ductus closure, means when the patent ductus arteriosus is closed, means patent ductus arteriosus means it is a connection between the aorta and then pulmonary artery. When it is closed means after 3 weeks only. Okay, that time the severe congestive heart failure is there. That child is having severe congestive heart failure and poor lower body perfusion. Okay, at the same time child is suffered with the tachypnea, acidosis, progressive circulation shock and absence of femoral and fetal pulse. Why this absence of femoral and then fetal pulse means because the coartation is present at the distal part of the aorta. So what happened here? The lower extremities is having decreased blood circulation. So absence of femoral and then fetal pulse is there. Okay, and coming to the in older children, the child or adolescent with a coartation of aorta are usually asymptomatic. Normally growth and development, child is having normal growth and development, but it is asymptomatic. When they are, what are the clinical features is there in that children or adolescent age group children means the hypertension in the upper extremities is there. Because high blood pressure is there in the upper extremities means the main organs, the systemic circulation is high. Blood pressure is there with a absence or weak femoral pulse is there. Easily we will recognize that child is suffered with this coartation of aorta. How we will recognize means whose baby is having lower hypotension in the lower extremities, hypertension in the upper extremities. That time we should recognize that child is suffered with the coartation of aorta. Okay. At the same time, some clinical features also is associated with that. What are the clinical features with means absent or weak femoral pulse. Whenever we are palpating the femoral pulse, it is sometimes we can't observe that femoral pulse and we can't feel. Weaker, absent of femoral pulses is there. At the same time, child is suffered with the nose bleeding. Because high blood pressure is there in the upper extremities. Means the whatever the blood is dumping in that the left ventricle. It is when the ventricle contraction it moves to the upper extremities only up to. The narrowing is there. No? So because of high pressure child is suffer with the nasal bleeding. Okay. Headache. And then leg cramps is there. Why this leg cramps? Because oxygenated blood was not supplied to the lower extremities. So, child is suffered with the leg cramps. These are the main clinical features in the coartation of aorta. All of you clear? And coming to the physical signs. Some physical signs is there. Here the child is having weak pulse in the lower extremities. Bounding pulse of the arms and then coarted vessels. Here, look at this image. How? This is the first image is having, this is the normal pulse, how the pulse beat is moving. This is the normal, if it is small or weak pulse, okay, weak pulse, that time the wave is like this only. When the larger bounding pulse, it is moving very high and then go to very low. So, this variation is called as bounding pulse. We are observed in this condition, child is suffered with the bounding pulse. Of the arms and then coarted vessels. Okay, because of coarted vessels, child is suffered with the bounding pulse. Mostly in the congenital heart diseases only, we will recognize the bounding pulse. Okay, and fall in systolic blood pressure in the lower extremities compared to the upper extremities. Okay, so this is about the physical signs and systemic hypertension in the upper extremities. Loud aortic murmurs audible at the S2 area. Okay, these are the loud aortic murmurs is we will recognize it at the S2 level or S2 area. Okay, next one is systolic ejection murmurs. Here we are audible the murmurs, that is systolic ejection murmurs. When the ventricle contraction, what happened here? The systolic ejection murmurs may we will heard. And next one is systolic ejection click. We will see in auscultate in these areas. Okay. These are the physical signs of the coartation of aorta. All of you clear? And coming to the diagnostic evaluations, first we will auscultate auscultation when it varies the non-specific systolic ejection murmurs. We will recognize some murmurs is there when it is systolic murmurs we are identifying. And then chest x-ray, it shows that cardiomegaly and then pulmonary edema or pulmonary nervous condition is there. Look at this image. This is the normal heart borderlines when we are doing the chest x-ray. Okay, this is the cardiomegaly. Megaly means extended part is there, heart. Okay, cardiomegaly is there. How? The cardiomegaly is there. This is the normal heart structure. This is the cardiomegalic heart structure when we are doing the chest x-ray. Okay, and then child is having pulmonary edema or pulmonary venous congestion. Okay, whenever we are checking the ECG, it varies the normal or right ventricular hypertrophy in the infant have left ventricular hypertrophy in older children. Okay, this is about the ECG shows that. And coming to the two-dimensional echogram that with Doppler study and then color flow mapping identifies area of the aortic arch narrowing and associated lesions, that is a bicuspid aortic wall. And then it is associated with the ventricular septal defects and then patent ductus arteriosus. These are the associated lesions we have to recognize under the two-dimensional echocardiogram. Okay, and invasive studies, that is cardiac catheterization, it shows that usually not noted to make the initial diagnosis. May need aortic angiography to identify colorectal vessels before the surgery. How far the vessels is narrowing, everything should be done under the cardiac catheterization. Okay, this is about the cardiac catheterization and cardiac mangenic reason CT scan. This is okay. So the cardiac magnetic resonance image may be done to non-invasively assess the location and degree of the narrowing and identify the collared vessels. So this is about the diagnostic evaluations to rule out the coartation of aorta, how far the narrowing is there. Okay, how far the hypoplasia is there in that part of the aorta, distal part of the aorta, everything should be ruled out. Okay, these are the diagnostic evaluations to rule out the coartation of aorta. And coming to the management, here the management is depending upon the severity of the narrowing or depending upon the location of the coartation. The infant's invas, infusion of prostaglandin, that is E1, and inotropic agents, diuretics should be used for the medical management of for this coartation of aorta. If it is narrowing is very small, that time the medical management is needed for that cases. That is prostaglandin, inotropic agents and diuretics are used for this for the medical management. The surgical intervention is balloon angioplasty and shunting, and surgical repair is there. Look at this picture. Here the narrowing, here the distal part of the aorta is having narrowing. So they are doing the surgical intervention. They are removing the ascending aorta branches. Okay, one branch here, the three branches is there. So they are removing and then do the anastomosis from here to here. And here the patch, they are using the patch to cover the narrowing. Here the they are removing this part area and then they are anastomosis the with one patches. Okay, so this is called as surgical intervention for the patch of coartation. And next one, here they are, here what happened, the narrowing is present here, so they are removing that narrowed part and then they are doing the ligation. Okay, here they are doing, here the total 6% of cases only they are doing. Okay, here in this condition what happens, same way they are removing that part and then descending aortic part and then anastomotic that part and then remove the whatever the narrowtic part and then they are make ligation in between that. Only 3% of cases only they are doing this, but mainly they are doing balloon angioplasty. Okay, look at this, here they are doing the balloon alone angioplasty. Coartation of aorta shunting. This is a coartation of aorta shunting. This is the balloon. They are inserting where the coartation is there, the narrowing part is there, and then after inserting of that catheter, they are infiltrate that catheter. Okay, and then just they are removing the balloon part, but here the shunt, the mesh, shunt means like a mesh, it is there, it is remaining in that area. So we are preventing the again and again then whether the narrowing is repeated means, so we are preventing because here the mesh is remaining there, so that is called as shunting. Okay, so this is called as coartation shunting. All of you clear? This is about the surgical intervention of coartation of aorta. What is the surgical intervention? That is balloon angioplasty and then shunting and then surgical repair. Okay, for all obstruction to the blood flow conditions, balloon valvotomy, balloon angioplasty, balloon therapy, dilatation, they are using. Remember. Okay, this is about the surgical intervention of coartation of aorta. Coming to the complications, here the complications are systemic hypertension and then congestive heart failure, cerebral hemorrhage, infective endocarditis, left ventricular failure and aortic aneurysm. Here the aortic aneurysm is there. What is aneurysm? Here the dilated, look at this image here. Here, this is the descending aorta. This descending aorta is supplies the blood to the lower extremities of the body. That is mainly it is supplies to the kidneys and then lower extremities. So what happened here? The aneurysm. Here the thoracic aortic aneurysm is there. When the dilatation, here the distal part it is there. That is called as thoracic aneurysm. Here the abdominal aneurysm is there. At the level of the kidney, here the aorta is having aneurysm. So we will recognize because these cases, the one of the complication is aortic aneurysm. If anyway the aortic is having aneurysm, at the same time child is suffered with the left ventricular failure. Look at this image here. This is the normal left ventricle. Okay, here the left ventricular failure because here the congestion is there, and then because of overloading of the left ventricle, here what happened, left ventricular failure is there. Okay, because of thickened muscles is present in the left side of the heart. Okay, this is these are the complications of coartation of aorta. All of it clear? I will repeat, summarize the topic. What is coartation of aorta? Coartation of aorta is a narrowing of the distal part of the aorta. What are the clinical features is there here? The clinical features is increased blood pressure in the upper extremities, decreased blood pressure in the lower extremities there. So the decreased blood pressure in the lower extremities, it means child is having absence or weak femoral pulse and cold and calm clammy skin over the lower extremities. Increased blood pressure in the upper extremities means here what happened, child is having nasal bleeding, headache, and then hypertension is there. Okay, these are the clinical features. So what is the surgical intervention? Balloon angioplasty, or they are doing the end-to-end anastomosis, or they are doing an anastomosis. Okay, remove that part where the narrowing is there, and then they are doing the anastomosis. That is called as end-to-end anastomosis. All of you clear? This is about the coartation of aorta. All of you clear?